in the last couple of years, we guys have moved from these large companies to the imaging and also cardiac imaging analysis. So because of some brand reasons, so this is what the technology started to present last year when we started with this. So one of my cases, customers was in the audience, and she also raised her hand. Yes, because we can answer you can take this. So we have the design tech still is the right thing to find a solution. You have made a positive process and ask the user to start to work with the brain scan. This might be the most important process to incorporate.
Thank you. 上堀地川で、町がありましたよ。上星川じゃないですか。では何相鉄手を押して和田町、和田彦さん、和田彦さん、相鉄線の上星川駅までやってまいりました。ここ歩くと和田町に着く。
Thing or service thing very quickly. What we're going to do is we're going to partition it up into chunks, parts of the network.
And then to do that, so we can, for example, map, let's say, four trunks onto four separate machines, right? And those machines have 16 GPUs, or they have a couple GPUs, it doesn't really matter. The important thing is that then that collection of machines collaborates in the process of doing this automatically. And so, to this little for example, just, if one machine keeps 16 GPUs, we get 64 GPUs working together on this one neural network, but that's still not fast enough, that's still not parallelized enough to the kind of things we want to do. So the way we add another layer of parallelism is that we take this four-partition version of the model and we make multiple replicas of it. So we now have three copies of the same neural network, and they're training on slightly different amounts of data. So you think they're all running different pieces of data, they're learning different things. How do they synchronize? How do they share what they're learning and their data? And the answer is that you do this with a separate set of machines. And the communication that allows the synchronization is actually very, very simple, where what happens is each version of the neural network sort of downloads the current version of the parameters, the state of the machine learning system, and it looks at the training data and it looks at how it thinks it should change, and sends that back to the parameters. And then you can then the parameter server can actually blindly incorporate the new wisdom from the simulation. And so the
entire
thing is a marketplace where each copy of the neural network is sort of bidding on what it thinks the value of this parameter should be given the information that it has. And over time, this information ends up being propagated and shared in the network collect. And given this, we come to the paper in we use over 10,000 GPUs streams as one neural network. So that would apply to have this crazy structure. And each of these is only set up as a valid, just because nobody's sharing detailed numbers. But we're pretty sure that the training is a neural network that works, but anyone else has training what you need by the network that's practical for real purposes, at least the vast thing. And can you put more data through a single neural network than anyone else would
be possible? City
works,
sure.
More real user services against neural networks than anyone else has. But does everyone need this? Does everyone out here in the audience need the kind of neural network infrastructure that Google has that the devices have? And the answer is definitely not. OCR, so reading text from images, but all the things that aren't related to vision or machine perception, but things like natural language understanding and machine translation, and Fox is up next, guys, talking more about
this. こんなことが好きなのかって言われますけどね。君はこんなことが好きなのかって言われますけど、やってます。はい、やってまーす。と日村さんが言っております。寒い。寒い。ついに。寒くなっております。
Hearing or vision or photo recognition, if it's anything like that, then we should basically try deep learning right away. But there's a lot of technology out there that doesn't have anything to do with photo search or
deep
learning. So the next question you ask yourself is, do you have a mountain of data?
Here's what we think about this device
approach that is working so well right now.
And if you do, the
answer is still going to try deep learning
right away.
It's probably smart machine learning that's going to take a similar model to the technology, like the digital regression, and then try deep learning afterwards. If you don't have a mountain of data, you probably should have a mountain of data. And the thing that I would recommend is to grab more data and then where your competition is.
Okay, so, you notice that on that roadmap, a lot of them
eventually ended in deep learning, so they're trying to question, well,
if all we could grow
that
eventually,
Christmas present.
Well, not necessarily, but there's a product. Christmas present, come to
see myself. And some of your alternatives, and some of your
users
who can't afford
the service
models, if you're not
going
to get that easy to do this, and you don't require expertise people have in-house yet. And another drawback that sometimes pulls people down is that the ultimately the things
we end up with is a
little bit more complex for us to
try to
figure out
how
to make these
networks
more scalable. So we expect deep learning to be able to work in a network that's more scalable. So that's the question
for me
is, what is the effective and efficient way to
make these networks more scalable?
I don't think that
Wadamachi.
I can't say right now, I don't know the answer.
Yokohama Kokudai gachiradeね, Wadamachi. Manabe-san.西島さんはどうなんでしょうか。僕はもう国内で言えばあれがいましたね。小松君という同級生です。何だったんでしょう。もちろんビーズじゃないですか。横浜国内ビーズの稲葉さんじゃないですか。和田町稲葉よし、和田町交差点でございます。
Right now, learning from examples is the thing that works the best. So you should be aware of these other two things that are out there. Take a look, pretend to do all three of these.
交差点から右に行くんです。こういうことか。ビーズの稲葉さん。じゃあビーズの曲でも。僕はビーズの。